Hey all, this is Gavresh and welcome to the winning side. Today's second match of the IPL will be played between Kolkata Knight Riders and Royal Challengers Bangalore at a home venue of Kolkata Knight Riders at Eden Gardens. This is no more a sluggish, spin-friendly Eden Garden pitch, but we have seen a drastic change in this pitch from the last season, and now this pitch supports fast bowler with its swing and bounce that is available on this pitch. This bounce is also helpful for the spinners, so both types of bowlers enjoy bowling on this. Batsmen also can score a big if they get in because of the good outfield that is available over here. So try to select a balanced team because this is a balanced pitch which will favor batsmen as well as bowlers. Try to select a maximum of safe players over here because we already seen few strange decisions taken by teams in the two matches. The one that have been already completed and one that just started. So try to select the safe players to get a maximum point. Yes, there are few players that are not 100% starter and you still have to select them because both teams have changed their players a lot from the last season and therefore no one is sure who will exactly start in the starting 11 of either of the team. Now let's the team. First, let's see who will start for Bangalore. What will be the starting 11? Probable. In wicketkeeper section, I think Parthiv Patel will start in this match. QDK also has a chance of starting this match and there may come time where both will start. But for this match, I think Parthiv Patel has a better chance of starting this match because we have seen that a lot of foreigners that have came to India for IPL after completing their test match series recently have not opted to play in the first match. So Parthiv Patel has a better chance and he will most probably open the inning with Brandon McCullum. I think when QDK will get into the team, Brandon McCullum will be dropped. But for this match, I think Brandon McCullum has a chance to start this match and open the inning. That means Virat Kohli will bat at number 3 and AB de Villiers at number 4. There is a lot of competition for number 5. There is a Sarfaraz Khan, there is Manan Hora and Mandeep Singh. But I think Sarfaraz Khan has a better chance of starting because he was retained by the Bengaluru, so they have certain plan for him. Mandeep Singh can also start this match because he used to play for Bengaluru, so they know how he bats. So I think Virat Kohli and AB de Villiers are the safe player over here with Brandon McCullum. Is I think 90% safe player. In all-rounder section, I think Colin D. Grandholm and Chris Oak will start because their other options are Moeen Ali and Pawan Negi and Corey Anderson who they added later because of the injury to Nathan Coulter-Nayar. Corey Anderson was not involved in international cricket for a long time, so I'm not sure about his form and fitness. And with other two spinners available, the two good international spinners in Washington Sundar and Yajuvendra Chahal, I don't see any need to add another spinner into the starting 11, and therefore Pawan Negi's and Moeen Ali's chances of starting this match are bleak, which means they have to go with Colin D. Grandholm and Chris Oak, both all-rounders needed to balance the team. Chris Oaks can be a trump card over here because of the swing that is available on the newly laid Eden Garden pitch. And he can also bat and give some valuable points over there. Then in bowling section, I think Umesh Yadav, Yajuvendra Chahal and Washington Sundar, these three picks themselves. And then one of the Khel, Jirolia, Chaudhary or Saini will start. Aniket Chaudhary used to play for Bangalore last season and he played in quite a few games in that season. So he has kind of upper hand over here. But Kulwant Khejrolia and Navdeep Saini had a very good domestic season. So team management may go with the form of these two and select one of these two in the starting 11. So Umesh Yadav, Yajuvendra Chahal and Washington Sundar are the safe choices over here. They also have a team Saudi available, and if they want to select him in the starting 11, then they may have to drop one of the foreigner from the all-rounder section or batting section, and that puts little bit question marks over Chris Oaks, Colin DeGrandom and McCallum. And that's why I said there are a lot of players in this match that are not exactly as 100% starter. So you have to take a little bit risk over here. I would still go with Chris Oaks and take that risk because I think he is an important player to balance the team for RCB. For Kolkata, Dinesh Karthik is a certain starter as he is a captain of the team. Then in batting section, I think Chris Lynn, Uthappa, Shubman Gill and Nitin Rana, these four will start. Shubman Gill is a superstar in the making. Robin Uthappa is an old horse and playing with Kolkata Knight Riders for a long time now. Chris Lynn is their opener. And Nitish Rana, they acquired from the Mumbai this season. And he's a very good batsman. So we covered five players over there. Then I think Andre Russell is there and Sunil Naren. These two are certain starter. The two players they retain. So we have now seven players. Remaining four players, there is a big confusion who will start. Because I think Kamlesh Nagarkoti will start over here. He is also an under-19 player who performed really well in recently concluded under-19 World Cup. He can consistently ball at around 140-145 km per hour and he can also contribute with the bat, so he's a very good choice for them. Then they may go with either of the Johnson or Tom Curran. It's a tough to say who will exactly start over here. Even Kuldeep Yadav's inclusion is little bit I would say risky because they have another spinner available in Piyush Chawla for them, who can also bat a little bit. So they can either go with Chawla or Yadav, or they can go with both of them into the team. They already have one spinner who is certain starter in Sunil Narine. So it's up to the team management if they want to go with three spinners or they want to go with the two spinners. So if you want to select a safe team, then I think in wicketkeeper section, you should go with Dinesh Karthik as he is a certain starter. In batting section, Virat Kohli and AB de Villiers, these two are certain starter. And for Kolkata, Chris Lynn, Uthappa, Shubman Gill and Nitish Rana, these four are certain starter. So I have selected Gill, Rana, de Villiers and Kohli in my team in batting section and Karthik as a wicketkeeper. In all-rounder section, I think Russell, Narine, these two are certain starter. I have taken a little bit risk by selecting Chris Oaks, but I think he should start this match to balance the team for RCB team. In bowling section from RCB, I have gone with Yadav and Chahal. If you want, you can go with Washington Sundar. He performed really well in that recently concluded Nidhas Trophy. For Kolkata, I think Kamlesh Nagarkoti will surely start, so I have selected only him in my team. So if you see the overall team, it is more of a balanced team. I would like to add another batsman from RCB team, but I was not sure who will exactly start for them in batting section. Therefore, I have gone with the safe players over here. And therefore, this team little bit favors a Kolkata team. But that doesn't matter because Kolkata is playing at home, so they will be favored to win this match. I have selected Kohli as a captain and Dinesh Karthik as a vice captain, but Dinesh Karthik will most probably bat at number 5 or 6, so he may not get to bat that many balls, and therefore if you want someone who will bat more prominently in this lineup, then you should go with Andre Russell because he will bat as well as he will give you 4 overs. Sunil Narine this season, I don't think he will open the inning. He will come to bat at most probably number 7-8, that means he will not get that many balls to face, so all the points that he can score is by bowling well, so he is no more a good option for a captaincy or vice captaincy. Yeah, if you want to take a little bit risk, then you can go with both captain vice captain from Bangalore team. In that case, you can go with Kohli as a captain and AB de Villiers as a vice captain, but that could be a little bit risky. Chris Oaks, if he plays, then he can be a good option because he can contribute with bat as well as ball. So that makes him a very good all rounder. It's up to you, whichever player you want to go with. If you want to take a little absolute risk, then you can go with Shubman Gill, considering his form in the under 19 tournament, and then recently concluded domestic OD one day tournaments. He was in a very good form. So it's up to you, whichever player you want to go with as a captain or vice captain. I think Kohli and Karthik are the safest option over here. So this is my team for this match. For more such videos, subscribe to our channel, The Winning Side. And if you like this video, then press that like button. And you can share this video among your friends, family, and on your social network. Thank you for watching this video. Bye.